Hey cuties, Peachy here. Welcome back to a new video. In this video, we're going over some exciting and finally some Bratz news again of the new 20th anniversary Rock Angels reproduction dolls. We got a lot of tea. Don't worry, I got y'all covered. So sit back, relax, and let's get into it. So the tea started like a couple of weeks ago, 2 weeks ago at the most, when we first got this overshot of all the dolls apparently looking like they were in final production. We also got two up close pictures of Roxy and Sasha. Now, these two pictures up close of these two girlies were very questionable because, as you can see, something about them is very, very, very off. Like, look at Roxy's face. She has a fish face, literally. And Sasha, I don't know why, but her eyes are even bigger than usual, and they seem to be even closer to each other than normally. So, like, you know, safe to say, these first peeks at what was to come were not very promising and scared the Bratz community very much. Then a while after, we got the remaining pictures of all the dolls up close. So here's Yasmin. I think overall here she looks the best, like, just because she also has the best quality picture and best angle out of the bunch, but nonetheless she's the best. And then here we have the rest. Okay, and here's Chloe. I think she actually looks kind of normal looking, at least, I mean, the angle is not helping, but at least from what we see, she looks somewhat like she used to in the original version. Here is Jade. Also, I think she has a very nice face screening, actually. And then here is Sasha. Oh, Sasha girl. She still looks very off to me. And so does Roxy. I don't know, the eyes, it's just the eyes, the adjustment, the placing, the sizes of the eyes. Something about that's just off to me with Roxy and Sasha. But Chloe, Jade, and Yasmin, they all of them, and I think Yasmin looks the best. They all look more normal to me. And then earlier this week, we received the official stock photos of these precious girlies. Now, on the stock photos themselves, I think most of them look good. Like here in the group shot, all of them look really cute. And I actually have some overall thoughts in general for the Rock Angels line personally, but I'll talk about that at the end. I don't want to bore y'all. So here's the tea. Let's get to them one by one. Starting with the best. First, here's Yasmin. And I gotta say, in general, like, they come with a lot of stuff. Like, they come with earrings, sunglasses, accessories, a second outfit, a brush, second pair of shoes, a microphone stand, and like a very special Rock Angels specialized doll stand. It's not really a doll stand, it's just like a stand that has pegs in it that connect to the shoe that they're wearing that has holes in it so they can stand by themselves. So that's really cool. So in general, I think these dolls have a lot of they have a lot of stuff. They have a second outfit and like accessories. So I think that's a really good value for the price, which I'm not even sure. Like, I think they cost like 30 something, which is expensive, but you know, you're getting a lot of good quality stuff. So I'm glad about it. Yeah, I mean, Yasmin just looks so cute. Like, I love her, again, her face greeting. I think she is the one that looks the most like an actual Bratz doll. You know, like, I think she looks the best out of the whole bunch. Like, just the pinnacle. Like, she's the 100%, like, she is the it Bratz doll in this series. The other ones still look like Bratz dolls, obviously, but they just, I don't know, it's just like the printing, something about them's off. And again, it's just the worst, like with Roxy and Sasha, Jade and Chloe, they both look still like very much more like Bratz dolls, like not like knockoffs, if you know what I mean. Like, but Yasmin here, she's like perfect basically. Like, I love her face screening, her detailing on her jacket, the jeans, the shoes, the guitar, the second outfit looks really cute. I like the sunglasses. And we're gonna see a lot more of recolors and reproduction of this shoe mold that we saw with the 2018 collector Bratz dolls, or at least that's where I know these shoe molds from. There, maybe they are already older shoe molds, but for me at least, I've only seen them on the collector dolls, so that's where I get the reference from. But that's not a biggie. We love to get more color variations and stuff, so you know, as long as the details there, how can I complain? But yeah, overall, I think she looks so good. Again, a lot of stuff here. I think her first outfit's my favorite. And the hat, I just think works really well. Her makeup's just really on point. Like, I love her. I love her eye color as well. It's so cute. And here is the second outfit. I think the earrings and the red shirt and the skirt looks really cute on her. I think it suits her well, the red tones and stuff. It really looks good on her. And here she is in the box. Now, as you can see, there's like a little QR code in the box where actually in the past is where they put the CD in. But now you just scan that QR code and it will direct you to like a YouTube video or like to the YouTube channel of the Bratz for you to see what they have, I guess. Which I don't know, I feel like that's kind of like a downgrade because, yeah, I know no one really uses CDs anymore, but still, I mean, it's nostalgia. They could have done something different at least, but they do have a poster, and I think the packaging looks really cute. Like, I think it looks really cute. Now, going from the best to one of the worst, here is Sasha. Oh, honey. Now, here's everything she comes with: bracelets, a microphone, the second outfit. Yeah, again, a lot of red actually in her outfit specifically, a lot of red. I think, I don't know, in her stock photos, she looks a little better, but the eyes are just still so close to each other. I'm not sure if that's just me. I'm not sure if that's how she looked like. You know, maybe that's a Sasha thing, but when I'm looking at her and like the 20th anniversary first wave Sasha that I have right now in front of me, they do not look alike. Like, the eyes are way bigger for some reason. Like, I don't understand it. But yeah, and like, yeah. Here is the second outfit. Again, I think it looks cute on her. The earrings, I think the red lipstick actually kind of works for her really well. And the skirt has a nice denim finish. So I think the second outfit is okay here as well. Like, it looks really cute on her. And here she is in a box. The boxes are basically the same, but yeah, I mean, they look good. The artwork obviously is different for each character. Also, the belt that she's wearing in her first outfit, really cute. Like, little details like that is really, like, on point. Like, I love that. The detailing is definitely, like, on the clothing, definitely really good. It's just the face ups, you know, it's kind of the screenings. It's just kind of like, what is going on here? And here is Roxy. Now, she actually looks a little bit better than what she looked like in the first tease we got of her. Her face up here looks a little bit better. Like, it doesn't look as much like she, has a fish eye, like fish eyes, like going in contrasting directions. Like, no, at least here she's looking straight at us with both eyes, so that's good at least. But yeah, like, everything she comes with is really cute. Like, I'm actually not sure if those actually look like the same earrings as that Yasmin had, so that's kind of sad that we have basically the same earring twice in this series. But, you know, I get it. It's a cool earring. It fits with him. So, yeah, she even comes with nail polish and, like, yeah, she looks really cool. Like, her pants and everything. And here is the second outfit. Now, I see why they have the earrings on her, because it does look good on her. The shirt, the mini skirt is really cute, actually. And also, the hair on all of these olds looks really cute. The coloring, the highlights, it looks just like the shading looks really nice, and yeah, so like, I think the second outfit looks really cute here as well. Here is the box again. Everything is the same, but she, I don't know, in the box she looks a little whack. Like, the eyes again, I don't know, like, the eyes I thought looked better, but just something about them, like, it just looks like the eyes are like very like they have some kind of filter on them that makes it look like they are kind of going around her head. Like, it just looks very like a fish eye, basically. I know it's not, but that's just, it just, something's off. It does look better than the teased picture we got a few weeks ago, but it still looks like, I don't know, just, it's not for me. Next up here is Jade. I think she's one of the ones that looks definitely like the best. Her overall outfit is slaying. Her makeup, her face up looks so good. Like, I love that lip choice they gave her, showing a little bit of teeth. Like, I love that. I think it looks so good on her. The shade looks so good on her. I like that she's also looking like to the left, on her perspective. I like that. I like when they do that because it gives them more character. And I think that's maybe a reason that Sasha and Roxy look kind of off, because they're looking right straight at us. And maybe that doesn't help the fact to make them look more accurate. I don't know. Maybe that's harder to make, harder to do with face screenings, to make the eyes look straight and make them look good. I don't know. Is it a thing? Because those are really the only two that really look a little off. Because like Yasmin, she's looking to one side. Jade is looking to one side. And Chloe is looking to one side. And those three look better than Sasha and Roxy. So is that a factor? Let me know down below if you believe that could be a reason behind them looking a little less like Brad Stoll. But yeah, overall, I think her outfit pieces are really nice. I love that she comes with a necklace and the little stones on her leather jacket, the belt. The detailing is really outstanding here. Like, that's really one of the best things you could think of with this line. So yeah, I have no complaints in that department. Here is her second outfit, and once again she has a red shirt on and kind of like a snake print mini skirt that looks so cute on her. I think also the hair with the kind of like dark brown and blonde looks really good on her. Like, really, it fits so well on her. And here is her box as well. Everything looks the same like they do with the other boxes. And actually here we can see a better look at the 20th anniversary, the 20 years logo that's to the far left of the corner of the box here. So at least we can see that logo a lot better here. Lastly but not least, here is Chloe. Now, see what I mean? She's looking to one side and she looks good. Like, her face up, her face screening looks really good. Like, I like also that they gave her over knee boots, like that thigh high boots. Like, I love that. I think it's good to give her something else because they all have denim jeans on, and so it makes them each look a little more different than the rest, right? So I think it looks good. I think her face up looks great. Her hat, her everything she comes with, I think looks very good. Here is her second outfit. Now, I'm kind of questioning whether the second pair of shoes she comes with is basically the same mold, but in like a different color, obviously. Like, I'm actually not sure, because the mold, if you look at them side by side, they look pretty much the same. They are both thigh-high boots, but they are basically in the opposite colors. So that's kind of, I don't know, that's kind of cheap to me. Like, giving her the same exact boot twice, just in different colors. Like, I don't know, is that how she came in the first wave, just getting two thigh-high boots that basically look the same but are in different colors? I don't know, that's kind of questionable to me. But everything else looks really good on her. And don't get me wrong, I love thigh-high boots, but like, why give her two of the same? Doesn't make sense to me. Here she is in the box. Yeah, again, she looks really cute. I love the belt. Again, the belts on these jeans are just doing it for me. It's so detailed, seriously. Now, the fun doesn't stop there, because we're also getting a reproduction of the car that came in that wave. I think that car originally came exclusive with one doll. I'm not sure if that's even true, but I think that was the case. It came exclusive with a doll, but here we can just get the car separately and by itself. So here is how it's gonna look like. It can hold two dolls at the same time. It looks really cute. I think they basically are using the same model. Everything's probably the exact same. Don't quote me on that, because I actually don't know how it looked like back in the day, but I'm pretty sure like they would not create a new model just for a reproduction. That would also not be a reproduction anymore. That would be something brand new. So it's basically the same model, but that's the whole point of the okay, moving on. I'm repeating myself. God, gosh darn it. The doors can be opened on both sides, which is really nice. The trunk can even be opened, and look at that little print on there of all the five girls in this series. Really cute. The lights light up at the front and at the back. I think that's really cool as well. Here it is in the front of the box, again showing us what it can do. I think the detailing at like in general is really good. I like the silver. I like the little silver writing brand thing at the side, at the back. As we can see here, it says Bratz. That I think that writing is really nice. It looks like it would be something a real car would have as a kind of like a brand marking or something. I'm really horrible at car talk, like car slang. I have no knowledge please don't come at me, but you know what I mean. Like, it looks really cool. I like it. The execution is really on top. Here it is at the back of the box. I really like that they showed the dolls kind of interacting with the car, kind of posing. I really like the scene here that's played out. It really looks nice, and it shows the rest, all the five dolls that are also in this line. So that's really cute. The only thing I would say is kind of fishy is that the two dolls that are sitting on the car have their knees bent, and like Bratz dolls don't really have knee articulation, like not to that degree. So I don't know if they're using like altered doll bodies there to pose, but all in all, I think that like they did a good job with the box, the design. I think it looks really cute. But yeah, that was the video. I hope y'all enjoyed. Be sure to give me a thumbs up if you did. Be sure to leave me any thoughts or questions you may have down below. Let me know what you thought of this, well, of the teases first, like the first leaks we got, and then what do you think of the finalized official stock photos we have of these 20th anniversary reproductions of Rock Angels. Do you have any fond memories? Did you collect these dolls when you were a kid? I personally do not have any memories, because I did not collect Bratz dolls as a kid, because we also just did not get Bratz dolls here where I live in Switzerland. Unfortunately, the only doll I ever got here that's like a Bratz doll was like a Bratz Boys Cameron mini doll, which I still have. He's adorable. Like, I loved him to bits. Like, he was like, I was obsessed with Bratz. I knew Bratz existed, but they didn't get sold here. At least I didn't remember them being sold here, because if they did, girl, I swear, I'm gonna tell you, I would have cried to my mom until she would have bought me those dolls. And you know, I was that kind of kid. Yes, I'm sorry, mom. But yeah, so I think hopefully they do get sold in like internationally, like for Europe at least, because like here in Europe, I've heard that we can kind of get the Bratz 20th anniversary dolls per Amazon. But I just feel like I really wish it would just get sold again in stores, because I really miss that, you know, just like seeing Monster High on shelves or Bratz dolls. Like, I would love to see that. That would like be so cool to me. But yeah, I don't know. Like, I just hope that it works out well, the 20th anniversary reproductions. And I hope that it will lead to a new era of Bratz dolls getting released. Like, I really hope they do, because Bratz dolls are really asked for them. You know, people are asking for Bratz, you know, like people are really fans, and me included. I think like they definitely have a spot in the doll aisle, in the doll universe. So what are they waiting for? But yeah, anyway, I'm excited for the reproductions. Personally, I will not buy I don't think I will buy any of them, because if I do, I know myself, I will be like obsessed until I get each of those five dolls, and that's just a lot of money. Like, knowing how expensive they could get here, it's too much money for me. Plus, again, like, even though I do like the dolls, like Chloe, Jade, and Yasmin, they look really good. Roxy and Sasha, just not good enough for me. Like, it's not worth buying the whole collection for me. It's just for two dolls that like look like fishes or something. even though the detailing is really nice, the box is really nice. Just like, I don't know. Plus, also the outfit choices, like the outfit pieces, like all of the second outfit choices, like the shirts, are all red basically. Yeah, they're all red. Like, the difference is that they have different prints, different cuffing maybe at the sleeves. Like, that's the only difference. And the mini skirts are more different, at least. They have a diversity from snakeskin to denim to, you know, to red to white to black, I believe. So at least it's more diverse. But I don't know why they had to make all the t-shirts red. Like, maybe that's just kind of like what they wore in the movie. Again, I did not grow up with Bratz, unfortunately, so I don't have the nostalgia to back me up here. But let me know what you thought of these stock photos. Will you be getting any of them? Yeah, are you excited? Let me know down below. And as always, don't forget to subscribe, hit notification bell if you don't want to miss any upcoming Bratz 20th anniversary doll news. Also, by the way, thank you so much to everyone who wished me a happy birthday on my last video. I appreciate that so much. Y'all are so sweet. Thank you. Thank you. And if you write down your birthday date on that video, I will try to remember it and shout you out in a future video. Stay safe, be kind. I hope to next time. Stay peachy. Kisses.